So prior to the recent 1080 operation, 90% of our nests had frequent stoat visits, including all the ones that produced a chick. Since the operation, it is early days, but we haven't detected any stoats at nests, so it's really encouraging. There's a long way to go. Those chicks need to make it for months before they're big enough to be safe, but this is a great start and I couldn't ask for more at this stage. Good abs, eh? Good crunches. Kiwi can be incredibly sneaky and nimble. Sometimes they'll go charging around, hissing and cracking twigs, and then sometimes there can be one right beside you and you don't even know it.
What I really love about kiwi is that they often look like kind of a bumbling animal. Often you see clips of it falling over. But they can live in the harshest, most rugged environments going out here in New Zealand, and they still cling on to survive, and they're real hardy buggers. yeah.
Donnie was saying the North Island ones are way less fluffy.
Yeah, I just couldn't get over even the subadult, just how furry its legs were. They sort of just that bottom half is just completely down.
I believe like in transmitter change season when we're handling loads and you know sometimes they'll stress more.
Yeah.
There's loads of feathers around, we collect them and we give them to Oraka Parima, the local iwi. Yeah. I believe they're slowly making a cloak with it.
Things were going real well in that we had a whole host of little chickies with carrying transmitters and we hadn't detected any stoats at the kiwi nests. This is the first time in this study that we've ever had chicks get anywhere near sort of 3 or 4 months old. So they're about probably the halfway mark at the moment to where they need to get to in terms of weight to be safe from stoats.
Hello. Your future is bright. Good to see you.
Ah, it's beautiful, eh?
All the little white ear dots. Its parents are bones and flint.
It's the first time I've had an opportunity to see them kind of visibly growing up. They'd grown heaps, they'd sort of turned into teenagers, they'd gone all gangly. They're not quite as fluffy, they seem to have the same number of feathers, but it's just, you know, spread over a lot more kiwi chick.
Okay, keep growing, keep not getting eaten by stoats. You're big and strong, have lots of babies. You've been a long time coming.
Unfortunately, a few weeks later, we started to lose chicks.
You can see the hole in the beech tree behind me where we just found the remains of T-Rex's chick. Beak, leg with a transmitter on it and a pile of feathers. It's a classic stoat predation. Just totally gutted that this chick has gone the same way as all the others so far.
9 chicks monitored and only 2 still alive. To see the first Christmas. So, yeah, I did find that pretty demoralizing and a bit tough to deal with. I tried for something for a long time. It was a big hit, actually. I found it pretty, pretty tough. It doesn't take many, I think. There's just 1 or 2 left behind, and they are fantastic at finding kiwi chicks, just roaming around, and they only need to encounter them once, and it's all over.
after a 1080 drop, the biggest challenge is the invasion. Although the wet jacket army is surrounded by a sea on three sides, so it can still swim. We also have a land barrier, slight land barrier of mountains, but the stoats will still move across there. We know 1080 works, it's just a matter of right time and coverage. This is just going to help us get better and better.
But it doesn't mean the season's at a loss, there's still some chicks alive.
So in the bag here we've got Commando's chick, which I'm expecting to be the first chick of the study to make it over 1 kilogram, which will in theory keep it safe from stoat predation. So there's a pretty big moment for me. Yes! Yes, it's miles over. 1.3 minus the bag, 1,150 grams. She'll beat that.
And here it is, first chick of the project to make it big enough to be a subadult and to be safe from stoat predation. Bright future ahead.
Yeah, so since the 1080 operation at Shy Lake, we've had a couple of seasons of kiwi monitoring. Last season, we had about 20% chick survival, and this year we had about 30%. That might not sound like much, but it's a heck of a lot more than the zero we had for the 3 years before that. And what we've seen so far is that that is enough to get that kiwi population increasing over the span of a few years, including a couple of kind of off years. Well, that was very obliging of it, wasn't it? Right through the clearing. So overall, I think we can say it's been pretty successful. We've grown kiwi population in this area. That was our goal. And what we want to do now is roll it out elsewhere.
I feel really fortunate to have taken over the project from Tim. He's done an amazing job over the past 4 or 5 years, so it's an amazing challenge, and yeah, it's an honour to be out in a site like this working with kiwi. I think what I'd really love to see in the kind of broader kiwi conservation world would be for people to be able to hear and maybe even see kiwi in their own backyard. And even maybe from their own houses. There's so many New Zealanders who haven't even heard, let alone seen a kiwi, that just for them to be able to experience what we kind of hear and see on a daily basis would be my dream, just to share what we've just experienced here. So after 3 years or so, we will experience a re-invasion of stoats. While we are surrounded by water and mountains, it's no barrier for a stoat. They will come back. So that, because of that, it's really important to continue our predator control out here.
So 1080 helps us hold the line and buy time for our native animals and plants. It's not an eradication tool, but there's a lot of great work going on to develop eradication tools so that we can go predator free. Our job in the meantime is to make sure that when those tools come online, there's still something there left to save. I've had the privilege to spend time on some of our pest-free islands, and I've seen and heard and felt what it should be like when there's just birdsong and life everywhere. I'd like it to be like that again everywhere. It used to be like that across these vast tracts of wilderness that we're lucky to still have. And I'm working to, I guess, restore that balance and bring it back to everywhere. It's something that everyone can have. And even out here in the wop-wops where nobody ever comes, I want to know that the kiwi are there calling, even if nobody's there to hear them. That's what we're working towards, and I like to think that we're getting closer.